The Calgary Police Service and the RCMP want to make the public aware that they may see an influx in outlaw motorcycle gang members, particularly members of the Hells Angels Motorcycle Club and their support clubs in the Calgary area for a pre-planned event. The Calgary Police Service, in partnership with the RCMP, will have a joint police presence throughout the city, monitoring the activity of those attending to ensure they abide by the law, including the Traffic Safety Act. We do not anticipate increased risk to the public safety. However, there is always the potential for violence associated with organized crime and motorcycle gangs. Motorcycle gangs host several events across Canada every year, and historically these types of gatherings have passed without incident. The CPS, however, will be enforcing the laws with this group as we would with any other citizen who contravenes them. The CPS and RCMP would like to encourage citizens to report all suspicious activity concerning outlaw motorcycle gangs by calling 911 for a crime in progress. The non-emergency line are by anonymously by contacting Crime Stoppers. Thank you.
First off, do the motorcycle gangs get in contact with you to let you know what's going on? What type of activities are we talking about? And the level of concern that you're expressing?
So, in this case, we became aware of this event through our criminal intelligence section. They did not contact us. However, we have reached out to them to let them know that we expect them to have a enjoyable and lawful event, and they've relayed back that their wishes are the same. And the level of concern here has more to do with the presence of up to 500 motorcycles in the city wearing gang insignia. We just want to make the public aware that we are aware of this event and we're prepared to deal with it if we need be, but we're not anticipating any problems.
Now, forgive me, I'm not too aware of this, but the outlaw motorcycle gang, are the Hells Angels a subset of them, or because they're kind of, you said especially in there. I don't quite understand the first line.
Sorry,
in the release it says the outlaw motorcycle gang, and then especially members of the Hells Angels?
Sorry, particularly members of the Hells Angels.
So they're two different gangs?
No, outlaw motorcycle gangs, I guess the best way to explain it without getting too much into the weeds here is, they refer to themselves as the One Percenters. The One Percenters was a label designated by the American Motorcycle Association, basically saying that only 1% of motorcycle gangs are outlaws, and members of these gangs wear a One Percenter patch, which identifies the wearer of that patch as somebody that doesn't abide by the law or follow the rules of society.
And so what is this event that they're here for?
This event, based on our criminal intelligence, is the 20th anniversary of the Calgary Hells Angels Motorcycle Chapter since their inception, and it's also a Canada ride. So we're expecting Hells Angels Motorcycle Club members from across Canada and their support clubs to be attending Calgary this weekend.
And what kind of events are we talking about here? Just drinking at bars, or like what kind of events will they partake in?
From the information we have suggests that they'll be hosting several social events at their clubhouse on 84th Street Southeast. However, aside from that, they may visit local establishments, go on motorcycle rides, and all sorts of activities like that.
Is it in a residential area, the clubhouse?
It's in the 3400 block of 84th Street, so it's kind of on the outskirts of Calgary.
So no neighbors?
I think there's some neighbors. Sorry, I haven't been there for a while.
Yeah.
So.
Will the RCMP be following these members across Canada, and how many are we talking about coming into this area?
I don't know the exact numbers, but there has been some activity reported up to me in terms of as the club members make their way to Calgary, but I'm essentially here with Inspector Brar to, we'll be working in partnership this weekend. Should there be any rides or anything requiring the partnership inside the city or outside the city, we'll be working together on that.
The RCMP laid 5 assault charges after on the May long weekend after a similar party in Saskatoon. What steps are you taking to make sure similar events don't happen here in Calgary?
Like I said earlier, we'll be monitoring their activities, and any kind of enforcement action would be taken like in any other criminal.
The RCMP were monitoring their activities in Saskatoon. Are you doing anything differently?
Sorry, I don't understand what you mean.
There was the Hells Angels had a party in Saskatoon in
yes.
May, and the RCMP just charged them on July 17th with 5 assault charges. I'm wondering if that experience has changed what you're doing here today. Because they did a very similar thing where they said they'd be monitoring and then they ended up having to charge five members.
Yeah, it's just like any other major event that takes place in the city. The Calgary Police Service will be monitoring it, in this case in conjunction with the RCMP and other law enforcement agencies from across Canada. And we will take enforcement in action as needed.
And you say
can you step, sorry, can you step closer to the mic?
Thanks. Sorry.
It says in the press release, in the coming days. Do you have a bit of a window where, in terms of a timeline, where this is all happening?
Yeah, we expect the events to start Friday, May 21st, so tomorrow. But we'll see motorcycle and their members roll into town as early as this morning. Last night, some came in. And it's expected to last until about Sunday evening.
How many again? I'm sorry.
We're anticipating about 500.
So how does that range in size? Because, I mean, assuming you've seen some of these events happen before in the city, 500, how does that compare to other years?
Because it's the Canada run, we're expecting people from all across Canada. Last, in 2014, we had a similar event with the Southland chapter. It was their five-year anniversary party, and about 300 members attended, and there was no real issues.
So just with 200 more than you've seen in previous years, is there any wrap-up in terms of security, or what other measures are you taking?
I won't get into details about the resources that are being deployed. However, I can assure you that we have sufficient plans in place to deal with that large of a group.
Now, when these outlaw gangs get together for these types of things, is this where you think a lot of high-level meetings go on, or is this like a business meeting for these guys? Is this what attracts your attention to?
You know what, this is, I'm not going to get into that, but this is a highly organized group with networks all across Canada, so that's all I can say at this time.
Where across Canada are you expecting members from?
Coast to coast.
Just everywhere, or do you have a sense of specific places they might be coming from?
From all over. From.
So you don't know where specifically they're coming from?
Coast to coast, every province.
Okay.
Yeah.
Would that include support clubs too?
Yes, yeah. It does, yeah.
And you said one in 2014 with 300 members. Do you mind going over how often you see this? Every couple of years, every 3 years?
Do you know what? I don't know the specifics about the mandated runs, but you know what? They host parties all across Canada every year, and they know that the police are watching these parties, so there's very rarely ever any major incidents.
But just in Calgary, do you know how often they have like a group, I guess, event here?
No, I couldn't tell you.
When this happens, do you tend to get calls from the public when they see patches turn up in town?
Yes, and we do, and that's the whole purpose behind this release, is to make the public aware that we have know about this event, and we've been tracking their movements, and we just want, there's no need to call us if they see a bunch of motorcycles driving down the street. However, if they observe any kind of criminality, we encourage the public to reach out to us.
You said this in the press release, but just mind going over, is there any concern for public safety here?
No, not in particular, other than the fact that there'll be a number of large groups of motorcycles driving down the street, so there's always concerns around traffic safety. We expect them to have a enjoyable and lawful event, and they've relayed back that their wishes are the same.